So now we know what is the meaning of the concept of computer or cyber forensic. We also need to understand the scope and significance of computer forensic. As we all know that computer and the internet, they represent the fastest growing technology tools used by criminals. There has been a rapid change in the technology, in the use of information technology, which has been used by criminals to commit crimes. The way, the manner, the mode in which crimes were committed have now been changed. Now, the old criminal activities have been converted into white collar crimes, and it is very easy to commit any criminal activity through the use of information technology, through the use of computer, through the use of internet. So crimes such as defamation, such as mischief, fraud, trespass, etc., now they do not require the traditional constituents to be committed. Information technology has provided much easier and much faster alternative methods to commit crime. For all these reasons, computer forensic is becoming increasingly popular among the nations and among the law enforcement agencies. It is now easier to commit cyber crime or white collar crime because they are non-violent crimes. They yield high profit, have relatively low risk of capture, and if caught and convicted, usually result in shorter prison sentences. And as already discussed, as we know that internet is borderless, it recognizes no boundaries, it has now become easier to commit crimes of transnational nature, the transnational cyber crimes. Now, the biggest issue and challenge in the study of internet crime is the problem of jurisdiction. The information technology has now totally changed the crime scene investigation. Now, due to dynamic nature of internet, a website which has been used to perpetrate a crime one day, it may be an altogether different website on another day, or maybe absent on the next day. A criminal can gain access from a different computer at a different location every time he logs in. Therefore, information technology, the use of computer or the use of internet has provided a lot of easier ways and easier means to commit the crime. With crimes such as identity theft, phishing, impersonation, fraud and similar other crimes enabled by the use of information technology, it is now easily possible for a criminal in one country to penetrate a crime, to make possible any criminal activity against a person who is a resident of another country, all the while using servers located in a third country. Therefore, the jurisdiction in such a situation is the main issue, is the main challenge. At the same time, with the advancement in technology, internet access and storage devices, they are all becoming smaller, they are becoming cheaper, they are becoming faster and more mobile. It has now become more convenient for criminals who are engaged in traditional crimes such as murder, kidnapping, terrorism, drug dealing, criminal hacking or any of such other crimes to maintain files with incriminating evidence on their computer. Therefore, the use of information technology or internet has now increased in case of committing criminal activities. In such a scenario, in such a situation, the scope and significance of computer forensic or cyber forensic becomes more relevant. It is very much imperative to use the tools and techniques of computer forensic to find out where the criminal is actually situated, where the criminal is located, and how he has given effect to the criminal activity. There are various stages involved in the procedure of computer forensic investigation. These stages can be broadly divided into four categories. The first is the collection and preservation of evidence. The second is extraction of evidence. The third is examination of evidence. And finally, the organization of evidence. After all these four stages, once the data is recovered and made presentable, it is taken to the court and produced before the court. Now, let us discuss each of these steps one by one. The collection and preservation of evidence. The entire procedure of collecting the data and preserving the data, it involves a number of further stages, such as identifying the nature and the location of data, preserving such data in a manner that minimizes interference with the original data, analysis of the data for intelligence and evidential purposes, and finally, presentation of the data and evidence derived from it in a court of law. The computer forensic experts, they are required to analyze the computer system, computer network, non-functioning of computer, cracking the password, audit trails, imaging or cloning of hard disk, etc. Everything, each of these activities in detail. The most immediate and important objective of the collection and preservation process is the imaging of the evidentiary evidence to take out multiple images, to take out multiple copies of the evidentiary device. The investigator must reproduce the forensically sound image of the computer media, which means that every bit or byte in the data area in the original evidence media should be accurately reproduced. Every bit or byte should be accurately reproduced, not just most of the bits and byte, but every bit and byte, so as to make sure that it is accurate and authentic. The image copy must contain identical content to the original. So, imaging is a very important step involved in the collection and preservation of data. The images are accepted as an accurate representation of the original digital media. Multiple copies of the images are created for different purposes. The tools which are commonly used for collection and preservation of evidence are software imaging tools, hardware imaging tools, imaging validation tools, and write blocking tools. The next step in this collection of computer forensic investigation is the extraction of evidence. This is the second most important step or stage after collection and preservation of data. The following tools are commonly used for the purpose of extraction of evidence: hidden data recovery tools, known file filtering, encryption identification tools, password recovery utilities, and virus detection capabilities. Once the data is collected and preserved, thereafter extracted, it requires to be examined. So, the third important stage in this procedure is examination of evidence. This is the third stage. The extracted evidence must be examined by the forensic investigator. The expert must refine and examine what has been collected. During this phase also, the investigator uses the available tools and techniques to target specific digital evidence. After refining his search, the investigator can focus only on relevant information. The general activities during examining the evidence are to search the computer for documents, to search for deleted files, to search for images, emails, etc. The commonly used tools for examining the evidence are file listing, file extension search utilities, and file identification and viewing utilities. And finally, once the data is collected, preserved, extracted, and examined, it needs to be organized. The filtered data needs to be organized properly so that it can be made presentable to be taken to a court. This stage is most critical and most important to the investigation. The examined data is systematically organized so as to be produced before the court of law. Commonly used tools for organization of evidence are link analysis tool and timelining utilities. You can see the diagram on the screen. The four stages are divided into the collection of evidence, the examination of evidence, followed by analysis of evidence, and finally, the evidence report is drafted or report is made, which is taken to the court. This is another pictorial representation of the four stages, which you can see on your screen. Step 1, investigation of network and computers on seizing of the data storage device. Step 2, this is isolation of evidence, preservation and cloning or making images, which is followed by step 3, the examination, the in-depth examination of data, and finally making of the legal report to be produced in the court. After having discussed all these stages in detail, there are many shortcomings involved in the procedure of computer forensic techniques. One of the biggest challenges posed by the information technology is the newness of the crime and the redundancy of the traditional legal provisions to deal with such cyber crimes. Now, there are old crimes such as theft, robbery, murder, kidnapping, mischief, fraud, defamation, which are mentioned in the Indian Penal Code. All these crimes can be done now with the help of information technology in a more easier way, in a non-violent way, and without tracing out the whereabouts of the criminal. But other than these old crimes, there is a new category of crime altogether known as cyber crime, which were not present earlier, not recognized as criminal activities earlier, but now these criminal activities are there, and the legal provisions in which are present in our legislation, it becomes difficult to deal with such crimes and to address such crimes. There is a significant gap between the cyber tools used by criminals and those available to the law enforcement authorities to investigate and prevent cyber crime. This is another challenge which needs to be addressed as soon as possible. Various shortcomings in the different forensic tools are lack of tools that verify data during acquisition process. There is also a lack of tools that collect volatile evidence. We also have lack of tools that collect data from active systems, and the current forensic tools are labor intensive. Similarly, there is lack of tools for operation or analysis of alternate operating system. There is lack of tools capable of viewing obscure file formats. There is inability to mount and examine a variety of operating systems. And there is lack of tools for discovery of hidden information. There is also lack of tools that assist in the correlation of intrusion detection data. There is lack of tools and techniques for analysis of distributed systems. And there is lack of tools to identify users of chat networks. So, having known all these shortcomings, there is an immediate requirement to address them and to procure such tools and techniques so that the gap between the tools used by criminals and the gap between the tools and techniques used by forensic investigators can be reduced.